Hi and welcome back to Real Help. In this weekly episode, I will teach you my dill pickles recipe that I have made for about 5 years now. I finally found the perfect recipe that keeps my cucumbers crunchy and sour. But first, let me give you a brief intro on what this channel is about. My name is Diana and I'm here to answer all of your cooking questions. This channel covers everything related to cooking, from how to make a cup of coffee to traditional recipes. So stick around if you are enthusiastic about home cooking and learning new dishes or finding new and easier methods to prepare, serve and preserve your food. If you love dill pickles and you are searching for a recipe that keeps them crunchy, look no further because you found it. After years of soggy pickles with almost no crunch and dozens of ratios tested, I finally found the perfect recipe for crisp, crunchy dill pickles. The secret stays in the vinegar-water ratio. If you change the ratio even a bit, the crunchiness is gone, and you'll have soggy pickles that no one wants. And the best part is they are extremely easy to make. Just follow these simple steps and enjoy your homemade dill pickles. Let's jump to the recipe. You'll need 5 kg or 11 pounds of cucumbers. Gherkins are the best, size matters. The smaller they are, the better they are. And not only for the taste, but it's a lot easier to feed them in jars. 3 liters or 0.8 gallons of water. 1 liter or 33 fluid ounces of vinegar. It doesn't really matter if it's regular vinegar or apple cider vinegar. What it counts is the concentration. You must use vinegar that has a concentration of 9 degrees. Dill. Now ideally would be the dill to be dried. I made this recipe both with fresh dill and dried. Pickles made with dry dill have a more highlighted dill flavor than the ones made with fresh one. Onions, carrots, garlic, mustard seeds, peppercorns, bay leaves, horseradish. Now, if you can skip using carrots, for example, or mustard seeds if you are allergic, this is the one ingredient that you must use. It has amazing preservation properties. It keeps the pickles nice and crisp and, as a bonus, gives them a nice spicy flavor. 4 tablespoons of salt. 1 tablespoon for each liter of liquid used. 5 tablespoons of sugar. If you want the pickles to have a more sweet flavor, you can up your sugar count to even 8 tablespoons. I like my pickles to be sour, and that's why I dropped the sugar level. To make the crunchiest dill pickles, start with fresh cucumbers. Look for cucumbers that are firm, dark green and small. Avoid cucumbers that are too big to fit in a jar, soft, or have brown spots. Use a washcloth to ease the cleaning process. My dill pickles recipe requires the cucumbers to be intact, no cutting, no slicing whatsoever. It will ruin the texture. To ease my work, I let them to sit in water for a few hours before starting the canning process. It will soften them a bit so I can place them in jars easier. Prepare the vegetables. Wash, clean and slice them. You can let the garlic intact after peeling. There is no need to crush it or slice it. Place the cucumbers in jars. Add a few slices of onions, some chopped carrots, 1 or maximum 2 cloves of garlic per jar, horseradish, mustard seeds and peppercorns, bay leaves and finally dill. Proceed like this until you finish all the cucumbers. Now that all the jars are set up, you can start preparing the brine solution. Put the water to boil, all 3 liters. Add the vinegar, salt and sugar, stir and let the whole mixture boil for about 5 minutes. Add boiling hot brine solution over the cucumbers. Make sure they are all completely submerged in liquid. Not even a small tip needs to be left uncovered. Close the jars and tighten the lid. Now, all these jars need to go through bain-marie operation. Take a big pot and arrange all the jars. They need to boil for 10 minutes after the first boiling bubble. You will see that during this boiling process, the cucumbers will change their color from a dark green to a sheen green. After the boiling process is done, make sure you remove the jars from hot water immediately and you let them cool off at room temperature. If you let the jars in hot water to cool off, the pickles will be soggy. After a few hours when they are completely cooled off, you can place them in your pantry. In about a month, they will be perfect for consumption. That's it! This is my dill pickles recipe that I have been making for quite some time now. I hope you try it because I know you will love it. Thanks for watching! Don't forget to subscribe, like and share!